Morning, everyone. Talks on how to stop Channel 9 from falling into receivership with the company bogged in $3.3 billion of debt are resuming this morning. 10 reporter Melinda Nusifora joins us now from Park Street in Sydney, outside where those talks are going on. Mel, is a rescue plan likely?
Well, Ron, David Gingell, the Nine CEO, was very tight-lipped as he walked into his lawyer's offices here this morning, although yesterday he said he was quietly optimistic. No doubt, though, these negotiations are going to come down to the wire. Talks have been going on for months now, and the negotiations went right into the night yesterday, but still no deal has been reached. If the two parties, Nine Entertainment and their debt holders, can't reach agreement today, it's very likely that by the end of the day, Channel 9 will be plunged into administration. Now, analysts have told Channel 10 this is not a result of poor management on behalf of Channel 9. This is all to do with residual debt from Nine's parent company, CVC Asia Pacific.
Mel, Channel 9, of course, isn't the only media network feeling the pinch at the moment. Dare I ask if it signals the end of free-to-air media as we know it?
Well, Ron, I mean, we're just seeing downturns right across the media sector lately. It's not just Channel 9 who's in a bit of a tight situation financially. Analysts have told us on 10 Breakfast this morning that this is a result of the poor economic climate that we're experiencing at the moment. A downturn in the retail sector has meant advertisers aren't spending as much, and that's where the majority of the profits come from in the media sector, and this could go on for a little while longer.
And the minute we have a federal election, which is about this time next year, we think there will be a very clear mandate for one or the other, and then we'll all get on with life and we'll start to spend much closer to the old patterns of spending.
Although things hopefully, as you just heard, will go back to the way they should be come maybe the middle of next year, analysts have said it won't ever be as rosy as we've seen it in the past.
All right, Melinda. Thank you. Melinda Nusifora in Sydney.